Hi pals, John here in beautiful Mount Dora with Sigma's 50 to 100.
We're driving cars on a Mars tonight. We're passing off to the stars tonight. We wanna go.
The Sigma 50 to 100 for Canon is not going to be the lightest lens in the world, but that's for good reason because it packs in a 1.8 maximum aperture throughout that zoom range. So there's a lot of glass in here. It's a very wide front element. But it's not so crazy heavy that it's unmanageable or unwieldy. It has a nice throw between its on its zoom ring. So not too fast, not too slow, just in that right spot where if you need to zoom quickly, you can, but it's gonna give you a nice even rotation throughout from one end to the other. We've paired it up today with Canon's R5 using Canon's standard adapter. And what happens when you plug this lens onto one of Canon's mirrorless cameras is that it will actually automatically crop in for you because this lens is actually designed for Canon's APS-C bodies. So what that means is that although it is a 50 to 100, it's actually more like an 80 to 160 1.8. So that's what you're getting when you use this lens. With this particular focal length, like I say, it's the equivalent of 80 to 160. You're competing almost with Tamron's 70 to 180 2.8 for Sony E-mount, except this is brighter because this is a 1.8 lens. So you're actually gonna get more light in, which gives you more bokeh, allows you to use faster shutter speeds without having to up your ISO. And so yeah, it's a fantastic little lens, good for sort of almost wide shots, good for your standard normal length shots, even getting up close to things as well. But enough of me talking, let's go check out this footage. If you have enjoyed this video, if you found it helpful or informative, or you just like the pretty pictures, please consider giving us a like, subscribe, share, smash a bell, tell a friend, and until next time, I'll see you soon.